Now, recycling. I think most of us agree it is absolutely worth doing. So when we're done using these, they can be made into something that can be used all over again.
Can I have the talking bottle? Thank you. But sadly, there's still way too much recycling going to landfill and too much waste going to recycling plants that shouldn't be.
So this recycling week, I went to the source to find out how we can make sure everything's going where it should. At this recycling facility in Auckland's Onehunga, close to a quarter of what's trucked in has to be trucked right back out to landfill.
A lot of people want to remove their guilt of putting things into landfill by putting in their recycling bin and hoping, wishing that it gets recycled. Unfortunately, it doesn't.
It just sort of becomes someone else's problem.
It becomes someone else's problem.
For 500,000 Tamaki Makaurau households, this is where your recycling comes to live another day. 1,000 truckloads each week full of recycling. Well, not that, nor that.
Polystyrene, that stuff not so good, shouldn't be in there. Anything that is soft plastic, carpet, anything textile shouldn't be in there. Chips packet, you know, chocolate wrappers, food, obviously. Appliances, clothing, hose, metal. Unfortunately, this site does receive things like dead animals or green waste, garden stuff that they can't process it. There isn't an outlet for it.
Across Aotearoa, recycling facilities are dealing with similar contamination problems. Most of what goes to landfill from this Auckland plant is just simply materials that can't be processed here. A small amount, less than 2%, could be recycled, but is too contaminated.
You can see a whole lot of food contamination over there.
Yeah.
There's recyclables within that. You know, you've got your Coke bottles, your milk bottles, but all that food is just devaluing the product to the point that it is not recycled.
So we're sending stuff to recycling we shouldn't, and no surprises, we're sending a lot to landfill that shouldn't be there either. Each year across the motu, 12.6 million tonnes of waste goes to landfill, but around 30% of that, close to 4 million tonnes, could have been recycled. Rate your recycling skills and knowledge.
Fairly basic.
If we get takeaways, then I'll just reuse the Tupperware instead of buying new ones.
When it comes to this plastic bit, we haven't been putting it in the recycle bin. It goes with the rubbish.
Oh, okay, and why is that?
Well, I'm never quite sure whether which part of the plastic system they're in.
Yes, to be fair, it's not always straightforward, so we put a few common items to the test: curbside recycling bin or rubbish bin.
If it's dirty, no landfill, and if it's like clean, if you wash it, recycling.
Well, this is obviously here. What is that? Either. I would put it here. Actually.
Put it here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Probably not.
These two are the tricky ones.
Okay.
They're actually both over here.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So a meat tray.
I never know that, to be honest, because there's no... I put it in the recycling, but I'm not sure.
Well, you're right. This would be great in the recycling. Well, given what we know about the amount of contamination going to our plants, there's no surprises that no one got it all right. So I always thought I was pretty switched on with the old recycling, and then discovered just the other day that these items, this cream cheese, this cottage cheese, this one even says please recycle on it, can't actually go in the recycling bin. They're made out of plastic number 6, and like these little yogurt pottles, they'll need to go in landfill. This plastic is one of the types due to be phased out by mid-2025. Goodman Fielder and Fonterra both say they're working on transitioning to recyclable options. In short, in most places you can recycle cardboard and paper, as well as glass bottles and jars, cans and tins, and plastics with numbers 1, 2 and 5. You do need pretty good eyesight to see some of the numbers though. No, that's definitely a 1. And your recycling needs to be clean and bigger than a post-it note. Do that and you'll make the job of these people a lot easier. In fact, we were curious about what messages those at the recycling coalface really wanted to get out there. And this is what they had to say.
No soft plastics, please.
Wash out your recyclables to prevent food contamination.
Soft plastics are not recyclable through our curbside collections, and no batteries in recycling or landfill for that matter.
Remove lids from everything and rinse all bottles and containers.
Please don't put soft plastics in your curbside recycling bin.
Remember to remove lids and place these in the rubbish instead, and no soft plastics.
And I'm sensing a theme here. The good news is you can recycle soft plastics and a raft of other things like clothing or e-waste or even Tetra Paks, just not in here.
As far as recycling goes, there's a whole lot more we can do, like being really mindful when we consume.
When it comes to these materials, what we need to be thinking is about the circular economy. We need to be thinking about materials that can be kept in circulation and becoming themselves again. So the likes of the glass, aluminium, you put it in your recycling bin and they turn into bottles and aluminium cans again.
While nailing your recycling will definitely get you a gold star, remember, recycling itself is not the gold standard for our waste problem.
Before you recycle, you should avoid or reduce how much you consume of that material. You should refuse as much as you can and reuse what you can't refuse or avoid, and then you recycle. So recycling is that fourth thing you should do.
Oh, I feel a bit guilty.
There's a lot to take in. You shouldn't feel guilty, but just, you know, everyone can step up their act a little bit, right? As far as the plastics are concerned, 1, 2, and 5, those are the numbers to remember. Those are the ones we can recycle.
Sour cream and those kids' yogurt bottles, which I occasionally like, they've been going in the recycling in the Jones household, so we're going to flick them over to the rubbish. Doesn't make you feel good that I'm sorry to all the people who've had to sort through. I never thought there were people sorting through other people's, you know, it's our mistakes they're trying to fix.
That's right.
I'm sorry.
But those are going to be fixed soon. Hopefully, so that's good. Look, your local council will have heaps of information on what you can recycle, and we have put some Recycling Week links up onto our Facebook page, including where you can take other things to be recycled.